Hello everyone, my name is Pirate Captain Toast, and today I want to bring the news a bit more seriously, because this situation is rather serious, and I don't think my usual Pirate Captain Toast stick is able to fit in at the moment, because what is happening is a Cuban restaurant owner is forced a list of demands by BLM protesters who are telling him that his store will be messed with unless he follows those demands. And doesn't that sound something familiar and completely messed up? These are indeed mafia tactics. These are tactics used by mob bosses in order to set up a defense racket. In order, what they're saying is pretty much, they go into your store or restaurant, and they say, "What a nice restaurant you have there. It would be a shame something would happen to it, or you would be called a istaphobe." And I'm going to tell you this story, because Black Lives Matter is indeed putting out a list of demands on businesses in Louisville. And a small business owner is fighting against it, thank God. And I hope he continues to fight against it. And I am here supporting him in the best way I can. And that's very little, because I don't have that many followers. And I'm trying to grow that number, but I'm working on it. Don't you worry. But I will try to make this trend and find a way to also help him. And yeah, and I'm going over the list of demands, because it's pretty much a racket. So the demands are that you at least have 23% and of your staff to be black, 23% of your inventory bought from black retailers, and or you pay 1.5% of your net sales to a black charity, and you should display a sign that you support the movement. Do you hear what that is? It is a defense racket. They are asking you that you pay them in order not to mess with your store or restaurant in this case. And what disturbs me the most is that you at least have to employ 23% of black staff. That means that you have to fire possibly white people because of their skin color. What's incredibly racist. And what's the scariest thing about this is it reminds me of 1940 Germany, because in 1940s Germany the same thing happened to the Jews. Small businesses were forced by the state to put out signs that it was forbidden for Jews to enter stores or participate in stores. And it was a slow but steady climb. It was some stores weren't allowed Jews in, then post offices, then supermarkets, then laundries, and eventually they were shipped off to you know where. And we are in the beginning phases of that same situation. It is scary, and I support this Cuban man to fight it for a store. If black people would have to come up to me with this list of ridiculous demands, then I would buy a gun. I would accept their demands, buy a gun, and tell them to F off if they come back expecting pay, and have my gun ready in order to protect myself. And this is exactly what happens when you have no police. Louisville is one of those cities in America who was very progressive, and it's happening all over the blue states, where black people are turning into the mob. And this all happens because people are defunding the police or getting rid of the police. And that is the biggest problem. You should not defund the police. You should put more funds in the police so they're able to train their police better, so they're able to get better equipment for to keep store owners safe and to keep this rabble in check. Because the insane people are running the insane asylum in this case. The patients are running the insane asylum. And here is an entire here's the entire letter of where they are calling into action for all black, indigenous and people of color to get rid of the hands of the white heterosexual patriarchy that's influencing culture as we know it, even though we're blackmailing a Cuban restaurant owner, what is Latino and a person of color. These people aren't out for equal rights. These people are out for power. They are evil, and you should oppose them. If evil grows when good men do nothing, and we now live in a civilization that forces good men to do nothing because all politician leaders are very weak and spineless, unable to stand up to clear terrorists willing to riot and make mobs in order to earn money or get power. And the only way you are able to defeat these people isn't by cowering in fear from them and accepting every demand they make, because if you give them an inch, they will take the whole mile. And I ask you to reject these BLM protesters, reject Black Lives Matter, because Black Lives Matter, because Black Lives do matter, but they do not matter for Black Lives Matter. And in order to make simpler what I said, I do believe Black Lives Matter, just like each and every other life matters. But I do not believe in the organization Black Lives Matter. And even some of the more radical leaders, like Alamara Brewster, who used to belong to the Black Panther Party, what was a very radical party at the time, well, pretty much the Black Lives Matter during the time that Martin Luther King was still alive. God, we can use someone like him at the moment, because race relationships are down the drain, not because black people are unable to work for themselves. They constantly see white people as some kind of evil. But isn't the case. We did things wrong in the past and also right now. I will not deny that. But that doesn't mean that everyone is exempt from evil. And with the Black Lives Matter riots and jazz, those are good examples of black people also being able to be evil. I will leave it at that, guys. Please subscribe to my channel. I would really like you guys subscribe to my channel. Share this video if you agree with this video and spread out this message. Leave a comment in order to criticize me. I do like your criticisms. And even though I say I throw you overboard, I will reiterate to you guys, I will not do that. It's just the persona. And last but not least, if you have any more questions, articles for me to look at, or anything else of interest, please send them to me via comment on YouTube or via my Twitter. I'm also still usually there, and I don't have that many followers, so please send me an article if you have a fun article for me to look at. And I bid you adieu.